Hi, fellas. This is Wayne, aka Tag the Average Gamer. I got Ryan Kona and X Mamba OG representing Team Tag. I want to just start asking you guys a couple of questions. The reason why I got you two guys in the lobby with me today is actually both of you are college students. Both of you are going to school, so correct. That yeah. So you know, so that tells me that you guys aspire to be more than just a YouTube commentator. Would that be a correct statement?
Correct.
Yeah, well, correct.
Okay. If that's the case, that means you're not relying on this YouTube money to actually pay your bills. Is that also correct?
Correct.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay, if that's correct, Mr. Kona, what are you in college studying?
Computer programming.
Okay, so you're going to be super smart. You're going to be one of them super geeks. You know what I mean?
Nah. Never did.
Nah. If you deal with, I mean, you got to embrace the term geek. Embrace it like you love it. If, you know, calling you a geek is not a slight. Actually, it's a term of endearment. It's actually saying, damn, dude, you got a brain on your head. You know what I'm saying? Don't be shy of that. Don't be shy. What about you, Mamba? What you studying?
I'm going to school for sports management.
Sports management. So you trying to get out there with the big dogs and make them make that real dollars with those athletes.
Yeah, I want to be an athletic director.
Okay. Of a specific sport, or doesn't matter?
Doesn't matter. Just know at the end of the day, it ends in six figures.
It ends in six figures. So what you're trying to say is, if LeBron needs his calf muscles massaged, you Johnny on the spot.
Yes.
So what year are you in college right now?
Junior.
So you're a junior, and Mamba, you're a junior as well, right?
Yes.
Okay, that's what's up. And the reason, you know, I'm asking these questions, because you got a lot of people out there that want to be YouTube commentators. But you also hear about a lot of YouTube commentators that are actually in college and doing this for fun, but they're not relying on YouTube to actually make a living. They're relying on education to take them further than what they're doing. And that's what I like. You know, you get a lot of commentaries out there that talk about fun stuff. Well, going to college, to me, that's fun stuff. Why? Because at the end of the day, once you guys graduate, you're going to be, you know, you're going to be able to make some money, and you ain't going to be worrying about YouTube to do it for you, because you got a lot of people out there thinking YouTube is the only way for them to go.
Yeah. And,
you know, and these kids, these, you know, these young people, and I'm always like, look, y'all can try this all day y'all if you want to, but at the end of the day, like I tell my son, when it's time to pay the bills, you got to get a job. And YouTube, you're going to spend more than you get. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I really never thought that much about the money, but you know how Wings like to go on his little rants on YouTube when he gets mad? And I think one day he mentioned how much they made. So I think he makes somewhere along the lines of like $8,000 a month, if I'm not mistaken. And he was complaining about that because he said White Boy and X-Jaws and Woody made two or three times as much as him, which I really don't know why he's complaining. It's not like he's actually working anyway, but that's when everybody started talking about money and all these channels started coming out of nowhere because everybody started hearing the numbers, and that's when they wanted to get in YouTube.
Yeah, but everybody knows it's a small percentage of people that, well, I shouldn't say everybody.
Yeah.
Most people with common sense, most people who are actually a little bit older, I would say that, or a little bit more educated, actually out of high school already, kind of know that you're not just going to up jump and make that type of money. And also, that's not consistent money.
Yeah. Okay?
He's making that money, but that's not consistent money. He's like a salesperson. Salespeople don't make the same thing every month to month. Some days they have a good month, some days they have a bad month. So those residuals, he gets upset and tries to gain more views and get sympathy, I think, in order to get that CPM count back up so he can make that money. That's what it's all about.
But you said, I got somebody trying to get in on this commentary, but I told him to hold on.
Who that?
Mr. Wave.
Oh, Mr. Wave Info?
Yeah.
Bring him on.
My bad. My Skype acting up, man.
Oh, it's all good. It's all good. We keep the party going.
Yeah, keep. I got him, man.
You got him in?
Yeah.
All I see is a question mark. Is he in yet?
Yeah, he's loading up. It's called Lamont.
There you go. Oh, my God.
What up, man?
H-Town in the house.
What's up, man?
What's good?
Chilling, man. Man, I got a lot of stuff, man. I got to tell you.
What you got? What's up?
Man, because you know I had applied to a couple of colleges or whatever.
Yeah.
They gave me, I got 2 denial letters in the mail, man.
Nah.
Yeah. I mean, I applied to like 6 different colleges. I'm still waiting for the others, but like, I didn't get accepted to U of H and Texas State in San Marcos.
Yeah, but you said you retook your SATs, right?
Yeah, but they was like, they didn't like take everything into consideration, like the type of classes I took and all the other
what's
stuff.
What's your GPA?
It was like a 2.9 or 3 or a 3.0.
If you get 3.0, you gotta get like what, 1,000
something
on your SAT?
Yo, just
1,200,
right?
Like 1,200?
Yeah.
So, y'all heard that?
That was funny.
Yeah.
That's our roommate's next, but hey, they building the law. So, hey, but yeah, like if you take the ACT yet?
Nah, I ain't take that yet.
Take the ACT too.
Man, like at this point, it's like it's too late now. I gotta just submit everything.
I mean, hey, you get if you apply multiple times.
Yeah, it ain't too late. It ain't too late.
You can still do it, bro.
Yep.
Nah, it ain't too late.
Yeah.
You talking to man? You're talking to college students right there. Hey, tell me, it ain't too late.
I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. The school I was going to, I was gonna play basketball. I had my stuff packed. I knew I was going to my roommate, everything. It was like a week, maybe a week and a half left before it was time for us to leave. They called me and said I still had to owe 10 grand. I was like, oh man, I'm not going to end up going to school. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right. So Indiana State was maybe, it's like an hour and 15 minutes away from my house. So I'm like, okay, this is my last chance. I applied on the weekend, like a Friday night. I applied. They got back to me like a Tuesday, and I came down Tuesday afternoon, did everything I had to do, had my room and everything by Wednesday morning, and was here that Saturday ready to start school. Like it happened so quick, but I swear to God, my senior year, I just knew I was going to one school. It did happen. I was like, man, I'm done. I'm just gonna sit at home and be a bum.
Yeah, but like if you're like. You know what I mean? It just feels depressing a little bit.
I mean, it do. I got a bunch of denials. I applied at a lot of schools, bro. Cause like coming out of high school, I was a good basketball player. I applied to like big D1 schools, and when I ain't get in, cause I ain't get a scholarship. So when I ain't get in, I was like, man, I'm done. I ain't gonna play basketball no more. I'm gonna forget it. Then this little D3 school hit me up. I'm like, okay, I can go there. Hoop. Then I realized that didn't happen. I was like, man, forget it. I'm just gonna apply to this last school, and if I don't get in, it's over. I'm just gonna forget about it.
Yeah.
And also, you got the option. I know it's probably not an option to 2-year junior college, then go to your 4-year university and just do it that way. Because then you get accepted to whatever school you want to. You know that, right?
Right. Yeah.
So
that's the option. I've been thinking about. I applied because I know Texas A&M. They got a 2-year university right into A&M, and it's like they still consider you an A&M student and everything like that.
Yeah, you know, you graduate from A&M and you stay in Texas, you got a job. You walking out school with a job. You know what I mean? Because we recruit, my job recruits for like the top 5 Texas schools, you know, UT, A&M, Texas Tech. I mean, they go to the HBCs as well. You know what I mean? So, I mean.
Oh, the historical black colleges or whatever?
Yeah.
I applied to like 2 of those. I'm still waiting for
Prairie View A&M. I mean, it's right down the street from you. You know
what yeah, I know I can get into Prairie View and like TSU, but I don't know. Like, I don't know, because like sometimes some people say, oh, it's not a good school. Like, not as far as academic wise, but it has a bad reputation. But then again, like other people tell me, like, I'm sleeping on it. You know what I mean?
I mean, I work with a dude right now. He graduated from Prairie View. He's actually an engineer, and he loved that school, man. I mean, he got a great education. Matter of fact, he used to work at the airport because he's what we call a he's a construction engineer, and so he helped build part of the DFW airport, and now he works where I work, and he's helping him, you know, do what we need to do at work. But
yeah,
I mean, he got a great education from there. I mean, I know a bunch of brothers. Most of the brothers that work at my job, they're all engineers, and they came from Prairie because that's where they were.
I can't blame my like. Also, like, I put my own self in this position. Because, like, like, the last couple of days, man, my mom been getting into it. She was yelling at me. She was like, yeah, you too smart not to be able to get into any college you want. But, like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Maybe I was just on that game too much or whatever like that. But, you know what I mean? Like,
don't let COD steal your dreams.
Like, come junior and senior year, now I'm starting to feel the effects of it a little bit.
Yeah. The pressure's on the things. Because you guys are in school, you're trying to take it to the next level. Ryan and Mamba are already in college. You're trying to get into college. And this is the thing. Like, I went into the military. And then after my military time, then I went to college. I got my bachelor's, and then I went back and I got my master's. So I'm always preaching. I'm always saying to kids, you know, go to school.